Hey everyone, it's Monica. So I'm back with another one of those pocket gift card holders that I created a few days ago. Could have been a week ago. I don't remember when I'm posting this video. But I'm using the same Jamie Cripps SVG file that I got from the Silhouette Design Store to create a gift card holder for one of my son's friends. We're going to a birthday party, so I just wanted to do a quick little holder to go ahead and put his gift card in. The kids are all into Bendy the Ink Machine, and that's the theme of the birthday party. So I decided to just make a really, really quick and simple gift card pocket using a Bendy the Ink Machine image. It's just very basic. So I did go ahead and do an assembly video very, very quickly. It's most likely going to be sped up, so this video isn't too long, but it will be inserted at the end of this main intro, and then you can go ahead and watch it if you want. So here is the file itself. Again, I used the exact same pocket. The file name and number will be linked in the description box below, as well as I will put it up on the screen here. And that's where you get the pocket and the tag itself. Another SVG file that I used from the Silhouette Design Store is this little balloon cluster. Again, I'll go ahead and put it here at the bottom of the screen, and I will also link it in the description box below. This little Bendy image I just found online and downloaded it and just fit it to size. I think I did 3.5 roughly, or 3.4. I can't remember what I sized it to. And then I just went ahead and matted it in a cream cardstock as well as black cardstock. Here, this little banner comes from, I think it's one of my paper tray ink dies. It's not really a big deal. I'm not going to go ahead and list what die I used since banner dies are easily found. And the happy birthday also comes from a paper tray ink stamp set that comes from the Keep It Simple Birthday 3, item number 3295. And that is pretty much it as far as it comes to the file. You can go ahead and cover the back. I do have matting for the back. I just decided not to do it on this one. It is for a kid. They're gonna end up throwing it away. It's not like they're gonna sit there and display this little pocket. So I did want to go ahead and do something super duper simple. Inside we have the tag. Again, these are kind of a tight fit because I am using heavyweight cardstock for all of the layers. So here you have a little gift card from my son to his friend. We just have a to and from stamp on the bottom, and my son wrote his friend's name as well as his own. And this is what goes inside the pocket itself. And that is pretty much it. So gotta fidget with it a little bit because there is a lot of layers due to the pocket being heavyweight and then the gift card being heavy. So here it is. So very quickly, you're gonna go ahead and see me put this together. Again, it's super simple and straightforward, nothing fancy. The kids here is a good way for me to do simple projects, since when I create for everybody else, I tend to go fancy, but kids is the perfect opportunity to go ahead and do simple. So yeah, really quick and simple. Go ahead and continue watching if you want to see me put this together. And that is it. Hope you enjoy, and I'll catch you guys in another video. Bye. Hey everyone, so here I am just gonna go ahead and put together this little pocket. I'm using my favorite adhesive to go ahead and glue everything down. Again, like I always mention, I really love the Tonic Deluxe adhesive. Well, I would say Nuvo. Tonic is a manufacturer, but it's under the brand Nuvo. Another one that I really, really love is the Art Glitter Dries Clear Glue. And I always go back and forth between the two. So here I'm just going ahead and gluing the pocket down. I'm gathering the different layers for the matting for the front of the pocket. And I'm just very quickly inking the edges with my Black Soot Distress Oxide ink. I do use my Distress Oxide because I did go ahead and get rid of all of my regular Distress inks. That's what I would typically ink the edges of all of my pages with. But since those are all gone, I'm using the Oxide. So I have sped this up just a tad so I can go ahead and get through this tutorial really, really quickly. There's nothing really over the top. It's pretty basic and straightforward. But I figured I'd go ahead and just do a voiceover instead of adding music. So here I am just gluing it to the back piece. Again, all of these mats do come with the file, except the brown mat that you see. The brown mat I created myself. All I did was create an offset to the original mat that they have. If you go with the mat that comes with the file, it gives you about a quarter of an inch border around everything. And that's too large of a border. I prefer about an eighth of an inch. So I create an offset. So here you have a little bendy image that I grabbed offline. And I'm also using an SVG file for the balloons. And we have the little happy birthday. So for the bendy file, I just grabbed the image, inserted it into Word, sized it to how I wanted, and then just went ahead and matted it with cream cardstock and then again with black cardstock. So right now I'm just kind of placing it where I want it. I do want the image hanging over the edge. So I'm kind of just fiddling around with the layout. I do pull the image back up because I did want it a little bit further in. So that was no issue. The glue hadn't dried yet. So I just lifted it back up and shifted it to the left a little bit more. I do not use dimensionals on any of this, so it's all flat. The little SVG file, here I'm thinking about putting dimensionals on it, and then I'm like, let's leave it alone. This is going to a 9-year-old boy. They're just going to end up throwing it away. It's not like they're keeping it. The little SVG file for the balloons, I did go ahead and put the design file in the intro of the video. Super simple to put together, just a few layers. All you have to do is resize it. This is a great file to definitely go larger. I probably will definitely do bigger balloons on this pocket for future use. So now I'm kind of just aligning where I want the balloons and everything else. All of the cardstock that I used is Recollections, the black, the cream, the brown, everything is from Recollections. The striped pattern paper in the background, it is a Simple Stories old line. It comes from the Documented line. This was from years and years ago. I have a whole bunch of 12 by 12 sheets from the collection, so I thought it was perfect to go with this pocket. Now I'm just going ahead and adhering the little banner to the little gift card pocket, and that is essentially it when it comes to the layout of the gift card pocket. Right here you have the tag where you can go ahead and insert the gift card. As you can see, the PlayStation ones are actually tall. It's not a standard card. They have a large little file, a little piece that you add to it, but it still fits within the gift card pocket item. I'm just going ahead and stamping the to and from on the bottom with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink, and that is pretty much it. That is another Paper Tree ink stamp, and I can't remember what it is. I will link it in the description box below, and that pretty much sums it up. Hope you enjoyed, and the file, again, it's super simple and easy to use. Alrighty, I'll catch you guys in another video. Bye!